Great. So hey guys, thank you very much for giving this opportunity. Rai, I think it's a great event going on, and I'm Sanjeev. I represent Unicommerce as a head of sales, and I'm going to talk about quickly on omnichannel and order management solutions. So to begin with, Unicommerce offers a couple of solutions like multi-channel solution, warehouse management solution, and omni-channel solution. So we are generally going to talk about what's the basic difference between multi-channel and omni-channel. And then we will eventually also talk about why omni-channel and why now, which is a more important question, right? So multi-channel basically revolves around a brand, a company where the brand is trying to sell on a store or a web or mobile or maybe a social media or phone, as you can see on my slide. Whereas in omni-channel, customer sits on the center and every channel revolves around the customer and tries to give a same experience across all channels. So that's what is the core difference between a multi-channel and a omni-channel solution. So in fact, what has also happened is omni-channel is basically trying to blur the gap between online and offline rather than we saying that which one is better. Omni-channel says that it's just an enablement of facilitating the customer to buy from whatever channel which can, and omni-channel means just to give the same seamless experience across any channel. So that's what basically talks about omni-channel. So let's first talk about what are the typical touch points where a customer might come. It could be a mobile app or a marketplace or social media or anything which you can see on my slide. And also there are multiple ways on which a customer interacts with a brand. Say for example, they can go on a search, they can go on a offline store, or maybe they can read a tweet or whatever it is, or maybe they go to the Facebook page. So interaction can happen at any level with the customer. It can happen from a escalation point as well, because many customers try to get better service and they can come for a resolution or a help or a complaint online and stuff like that. So wherever they come and interact, the brand communication has to be the same. So these are a couple of channels on which they can come and connect. So that means that we need to have an omni-channel experience giving to the customer. So why now? Why now? Because if you look at the current pandemic where situation has become a bit hard, you know, which causing severe effects on retailers, brands, even SMBs. So it is all the more reason for us to be omnipresent, because customer is talking about doorstep delivery, restructure the operation in post-lockdown is what a lot of brands have already done. So there are many factors which says that we need to be omnipresent so that we are ready for a pandemic or any hard situation henceforth which may arise. Right? So let's look at which are the sectors which will get affected out of this omni-channel as a solution in this COVID or maybe post-COVID era. So apparel will go strong as usual. I mean, I'm not going to talk much about that. But the industry which is going to get impacted most on a positive way if they are omnipresent is going to be food and grocery, because a lot of Indian population is going to shift for the experience on buying first time online, which is going to be a huge surge in food and grocery industry. So we need to watch out this category. And I would recommend that apart from apparel or home furnishing, electronics, food and grocery category people should be omnipresent. So basically, how do we go about it? And let's look at some impact first, what it actually does when we implement omnichannel successfully. So the first thing it does is it increases revenue, because obviously we are going to save our sales. Obviously, when you save a sales, you grow your revenue, right? It also increases your customer satisfaction to a great level. Then we also talk about decreasing the CAC, customer acquisition cost, or maybe the customer return cost, which is a huge cost these days. So we can drastically reduce that. And obviously logistic cost also, because we are shipping or we are giving the right product to the customer. So these are a couple of impacts which can happen, right? From implementing omnichannel solution successfully. So we definitely should seriously start thinking about that. Not only to the customer, but our internal customers who are our employees basically, because they also need to know why omnichannel, because generally there is a push when you try to adopt some new technology. But I think omnichannel will only help our internal customers. That is because a view of one catalog at any across all channels, one view of inventory, and maybe when a customer also visits, he also gets one view. If he goes to a store, if he goes to a website, if he goes to a social page, he looks at the same type of products and same experience from the brand communication, right? So basically, these are some of the channels which have successfully already implemented omnichannel, or maybe at least betting big here, which is like Flipkart, Amazon, Myntra, and Tata Click. And obviously, there are many more. So omnichannel retail is a compulsory adoption now onwards, I would say post-COVID era, because these are a couple of brands those have already adopted omnichannel. One is Big Bazaar, Spencer's, Amazon, which I have already mentioned previously. So we need to look at investing in omnichannel is what would be my recommendation to the brands, to the customers, because if you look at one of the international brands, Nike, they have even gone out to take decisions like shutting down maybe a couple of stores and focusing more on e-commerce so that digitally they increase their customer retention and loyalty. So that's what omnichannel talks about, right? So that's where we are. I think I've covered this point. So Unicommerce, we have successfully implemented a couple of Indian brands, which is Chumbak is one, TCNS is one of the another hugely successfully implemented omnichannel client for us. And they are really, really doing great. Being Human is another. We have Sazay, which is a luxury brand, which generally we speak that luxury brands go a bit slow on omnichannel, which is not the case here, because Sazay has very successfully implemented omnichannel and getting obviously a positive traction in their revenue and decreasing their cost, which I have already mentioned previously. So let me give some more data around it, how it impacts a brand when they adopt omnichannel in a positive way. So this is typically about TCNS, who have large brands like W. I'm sure we all know about it, Aurela, and a couple of more brands, 11. So this brand generally had a challenge of holding full inventories at each location, and they had no option, right? So once they got a full view of inventory lying in any of the stores or any of the scattered warehouses anywhere, the fulfillment, which was a mandatory thing, which functioned nicely for that brand. So what actually it did is, as I mentioned here in my PPT, 99.5% express shipping accuracy. So accuracy improved, CSAT also improved because of obviously timely delivery, and drop-in shipping also improved by 13%. So clear matrix for any brand to understand that why should I implement omnichannel successfully. And obviously, logistic cost was also reduced by 23% by doing this adoption rightly. So this clearly says that omnichannel is the way forward, and obviously now. So that's what I wanted to talk about omnichannel. And thank you very much again. This is Sanjeev signing off. But before that, you guys can reach out to me directly or on my email, which is there on the screen. And we can take that forward from there. Yeah. Thank you very much.